In this video today, I'm going to show you how to design better LinkedIn carousels. I also have two other videos about carousels. One is about why you should make carousels, and the other one is a step-by-step tutorial on how to create the carousels. I use Keynote on Mac. You can also use Google Slides or Microsoft PowerPoint, and carousels are really easy to make. And this is the video all about how to design your carousels to look aesthetic, to look appealing, and to really, really draw in attention for your business or for your personal brand. If you find this video useful, please do give me a like and subscribe for more videos and more content about how to maximize your LinkedIn content. So now let's get into exactly how you can design a better, more aesthetic LinkedIn carousel. As always, here's a summary of the key takeaway message in case you just want to take that and you want to get started. So your carousels are going to get more engagement, more reach, and they're going to spark more of an interest in people if you use imagery, if you write concisely, if you use bold colors, if you brand your banner, and in your design, if you include a call to action. So once someone's engaged and they've enjoyed your content, you then direct them to another resource, maybe your website or your blog. So let's tackle these concepts one by one, and I'll show you exactly why these elements are going to improve the design of your carousel. If you're creating a carousel, you should be using images. If not, then maybe just write a text post or create a LinkedIn article instead. You must use images to really stand out and to capture someone's attention. There's so many free resources that you can use. For example, I recommend Unsplash, which is a great website for professional royalty-free images, which will make your design look really, really professional. You may have seen in my video about how to create a carousel that I like to use emojis. If you're not sure on how to get emojis, you can visit Emojipedia, which is a free resource, and all you need to do is copy and paste those emojis into your carousel. A friend of mine called Yaf created an incredible LinkedIn carousel, which I'll show you guys here. And he used a website called Pixel True to kind of get the icons that you can see here. It really does look professional, and it looks like it's been professionally designed. And what people tend to forget when they're scrolling through content, we subconsciously think that if we see a nice icon or a design, we think that person's made it. So do make use of these free resources and really do kind of jazz up your carousel document and really improve the design. Because if it looks high quality, people are gonna think that there's high quality information that they should be consuming, and they're much more likely gonna be scrolling through and getting to the end of your carousel to consume all the information that you've put in there. In the video where I do create my carousel, and do check that out if you haven't watched it already, I show you my little tactic of overlapping images across the slides. This is really simple to do, and when you're on LinkedIn and you're looking at the carousel, it really does encourage that someone swipes through because they can see half of the image, which means they can either see half the image and they want to see the rest of it, or they actually get a peek of what the next slide is going to be. And that's really good at getting someone to go all the way through your carousel. And in particular, on the first slide, it's great to have arrows to encourage someone to start going through. Once you've got them through the first couple of slides, they're going to want to stay to the end to consume all the information, because FOMO is a thing, the fear of missing out is a thing, and people are going to want to make sure they get to the end and they consume everything you have to say if you've correctly captured their attention. So that's using imagery, and you should also be writing concisely. What do you usually do when you're faced with a paragraph of text, especially if you've not actually sought out that information? Chances are you're just going to scroll past it. You won't even read it. Now, in contrast, if you write concisely and you stick to a few sentences and focus on your main points, and you really focus on clarity of message, you could be more confident that someone's actually consumed that information. This is why on LinkedIn, broetry, where you space out your content in text posts, is seen to work more. If there's block paragraphs, people just don't consume the content. And the reason why is that people behave differently across different platforms. On LinkedIn, if someone's just scrolling, they want to see content that piques their interest, they'll stop and they'll read a little bit of it. When someone's in that scrolling mindset, they're not really ready to be confronted with a paragraph. In contrast, when you go to YouTube, you're more primed to sit and perhaps watch a video for 10 minutes about how to design better LinkedIn carousels. You've sat and you've watched this video, your intent is there, and you're primed to kind of stay, hopefully, to the end of the video. So when you write the copy on your carousel and you write your text, it's always good to pause and to think that if a stranger came across this content, realistically, are they actually going to read it? You can always test it on a friend. You can send to them and just say realistically, here's my carousel and how much did you read of each slide? The important thing to remember is that as you wrote the content, you know that it's valuable. However, someone coming across the content doesn't know what's in store for them, and they don't know if it's good content or not content. So it's best to be concise and increase the likelihood that your content is actually consumed. In combination with the first point I said, use images and text to really break up when someone might actually get bored and click off the post. Another way to design better LinkedIn carousels is to use bold colors. In my video discussing why you should make LinkedIn carousels, I touch a lot about branding and how you should use colors to portray your brand. If something's bright and colorful in the feed, you are gonna stop and you're gonna look at it. and you can only really get bright colors across if you're creating videos or if you're using images. You can't do that on a text post where you're limited to maybe just the color of emojis. So if you find a color, a particular color that you want your document to be, you can use color pickers online to take that exact color and put it into your document. This is really simple to do, and it's all about the hex code. You could either use a Google Chrome extension like I do called Color Picker, where you find an image online or anything, and you take that exact color, you take the hex code, and you just input that into Keynote. It's really important if you've got a personal brand or a business brand to have that consistency across platforms and across your content. Because if someone just scrolls through your post, if they just caught your color, they're gonna know that it was you who created that post. Whereas if it's a text post, if someone just scrolls past, they're not really gonna know who creates that content. If you don't use Google Chrome, you can also type into Google image color picker tool, and all you do is you find an image online, you upload it, and then you take that exact color. And like I said, you can just put it straight into Keynote, into Microsoft PowerPoint or Slides, and you can format your carousel post to be that exact color. My next tip on how to design better LinkedIn carousels is to really brand up the carousel. As I've just touched on with colors, if you have a brand color, you should definitely be using it in your document. But you shouldn't just stop with color. You can also include your logo because you've got lots of space to work with, or maybe a slogan like your brand slogan. As you can see here, so my personal brand, I just have my initials, which is JG. I have my orange, and yeah, I've just included that in the document because if someone's scrolling through the content, they're gonna subconsciously see the content, and if they like it, they're also gonna see my name, and that's just that positive association with your brand that you've delivered content which they've seen as being valuable. And finally, you should be including a call to action, a CTA, in your carousel. You should really include a call to action on every piece of content that you create. Even if it's just encouraging people to comment and asking their opinion on the content you've created. If someone's got to the end of your content, whether that's a text post or if they've scrolled all the way to the end of their carousel, chances are they're engaged and they enjoy the message that you've conveyed. So why not direct them onto other content that they might also like? I see this as going above and beyond for your audience. You should always be focusing as a content creator to provide as much value to your audience as you can. So on every slide of the carousel, you could have, for example, your website URL at the bottom. That would act as a call to action. But of course, the best place to have a call to action is at the end of the carousel. And keep this in mind, because you don't want your carousel to have too many slides, say 20, that no one actually gets to the end and sees this call to action. It's much better to have 5 or 10, where you can be more confident that someone gets to the end and they've consumed all of your information. So if you don't have a website or a blog or a clear resource to show somebody, you should definitely, at the end of your carousel, you should be directing people to comment in the comment section. So if someone comments on your post, they're gonna be showing also their audience your piece of content. It's gonna appear in their feeds. The comments are really your way to get more views and more eyeballs on your content, subsequently on your profile and your business. So your last slide could say, please tell me in the comments if you found this useful. You could say, if you've done, for example, here are my 5 productivity tools, and you could say, what are your favorite productivity tools? Or you, for example, spoken about how to design better LinkedIn carousels, you could say at the end, is there anything that I've missed? By asking questions, you're gonna much likely more get comments. You don't want somebody to stop, consume your content, and then forget completely all about it. Once they're engaged, you have to direct them to somewhere else. For me, what I like to do is I like to go above and beyond. So for example, at the end of the carousel, I might link to a free resource that I've created. So for example, I have a LinkedIn content checklist, which is my 10 things that I would recommend you do for every piece of content that you create to optimize your content. I will include this in the description box. You can grab it in this video if you like, but I like to direct people to more free resources because at that point you've given them value, and then you give them even more value. And that's how you can really turn followers or your connections into fans of your content who keep coming back to you and engaging with your content. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope you've got some value from this video on how to design better LinkedIn carousels. Do be sure to check out my 2 other videos about LinkedIn carousels, why you should be creating them, which hopefully is clear now, and then my step-by-step tutorial on how to actually design your carousel. Coupled with this video on how to create a more aesthetic design and the key things to remember, you're gonna be creating a really good, high quality bit of content. If you did like this video, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more ways to maximize your LinkedIn content. And of course, do share this video to anyone who it might be of value to. I really appreciate your time, and hopefully I'll be able to talk to you in the comments.